ABBYY FlexiCapture export settings. We'll go over different types of exports, the data export step, settings that you can create to define how to export documents, and different formats that you can export to. We can export field data to files, XML, CSV, XLS. The XML file is very configurable. We can export to databases, making an ODBC connection to the database. We have a connect agent to Microsoft SharePoint. We can export to a variety of applications using scripts. And we can also export the documents in various image formats, TIFF, JPEG, PDF. If we want to export a PDF, that PDF could be configured to include the entire document text. We perform full page OCR on all the pages of a document, including annex pages, and we would produce a searchable PDF. The processing station is responsible for performing the data exports. It's an automatic step. And we set up the exports, and you can have more than one, in the document definition. So the document definition menu looks like this. The document definition properties allow you to specify export settings right there. In a project, you have the option of setting up a root folder for your exports. And what that means is in project properties on the general tab, you can set a root folder. And if you do, all the document definition export paths will be appended to that root folder. So it's an optional approach, but if you do that, what will happen is pretty logical. We've specified here a root folder, and then we might have a relative path that we set up in the document definition right there. And so when it's actual export time, the export consists of the root folder. And then appended to that is each document definition's relative path. And notice we're using a UNC path here. So document batches that have been exported are deleted automatically after 14 days. And you can change that time specification. And you can also break up batches so that if I've got a batch of 10 documents and 7 of those 10 don't need to be verified, they can be directly exported, and that retains only 3 of the 10, and the 3 go to verification. So batches can be broken up in that manner. And there's the issue of unrecognized documents. At the batch type level, you can set up, there's an export tab when you look at a batch type, and you can set up a path for documents for exporting unknown documents. And that's a very handy and convenient technique. If you don't set up that technique and your batch has unknown documents, then that batch will flow to your exception folder. It's a great idea to export to multiple destinations. Sometimes if your documents have personal information, I recommend setting up a redacted export and an unredacted export. So if you ever need to share your data wherever, you can share the redacted data and then have another copy for your original use case where nothing is redacted. Also, when you set up exports, you're given a menu with different options. You can set up an export where documents contain no errors, and that's the best setting for production. But you can also turn off verification altogether. And if so, you may want to set up an export for documents that contain no errors, and set up a different export for documents that do contain errors so that you can address those errors at some downstream process, at some point after it's exported from FlexiCapture. And if you're just merely doing demos or doing a little bit of development work, you may want to set up an export where errors are irrelevant so that at any time you can export whether there's characters that need correction or not. So we talked briefly about some of the capabilities, and there are many, of FlexiCapture to export to files, to databases, to different file formats such as XML, CSV, XLS, to image formats, to searchable PDFs. It's a great idea to export to multiple destinations. I think another best practice is, let's say you don't have documents that have personal information, and your goal is just to export to a database. I think it's a great idea to set up an export where the forms also get exported to a fully text searchable PDF file as just kind of a safety net, an additional archive. And lastly, a reminder that the export is carried out by the processing station.